Hi, I'm Evan with GraniteFuel, and I'm going to be taking you through one of our new biogas upgrading facilities. The first step in our process is H2S removal. So the system here includes two static media vessels. Each of these are filled with ferrosort media. In the center here, we have our lead leg valve skid. So this is what's gonna allow you some flexibility in how you operate the system. You can run your vessels in parallel or in a lead leg sequence so that you can replace the media in one of the vessels while you still run gas through the other. You can see that all of the condensate from the vessels gets routed back onto the lead leg valve skid. All condensate lines on the skid are heat trace and insulated for all climates, all weather, all seasons. Once all the H2S has been removed from the system, gas gets sent over here to our low pressure blower system. The gas is going to enter the system here and it's going to be ran through one of two particulate filters. This is going to remove any dust that might carry over from the H2S media. From there, the gas is boosted by one of these three regenerative blowers. The gas gets boosted from anywhere between 5 to 7 psi, and we run three blowers in parallel for added turndown and added redundancy in the system. Next step in the process, the gas goes through one of our air coolers to remove some of that extra heat the blowers add into the system. And then once it's been pressurized, it's going to get sent to our moisture removal system down here. Now, our moisture removal system is comprised of two shell and tube heat exchangers, a knockout tank, and an off-skid glycol chiller. The gas comes in the economizer where it gets pre-cooled. From there, it's sent through the condenser here. The gas is gonna drop down to about 40 degrees Fahrenheit, and all the liquid water that's gonna form as a result of that cooling is gonna collect in our knockout tank here. The knockout tank has a number of level switches and an automated drain valve to make sure all the moisture, all the liquid water gets drained out without breaking the vapor barrier on the system. The gas then exits out of the system. It's going to be below about 0.5% H2O. Next step in the process, it gets sent over to our activated carbon polishing system. Again, we have two vessels with static media and a lead leg valve skid. This step in the process is just to remove any latent VOCs you might have in your biogas, any siloxanes, anything else that might impact the downstream upgrading process. Once we're satisfied that the gas is clean and ready to be upgraded, it's going to come over here to our GraniteFuel compression system. So the compression system is comprised of multiple parallel compressors. Again, we're looking at added redundancy, added turndown for the system. These are going to boost our biogas up to about 180 psi. Once the gas has been pressurized, it's gonna flow through another air cooler, and then we have downstream heat exchangers and coalescing filters. These are gonna remove any liquid water droplets that might form in the system. There's a final activated carbon polishing tank, again, to remove any oil that might have carried over from the compressors, just to make sure that the gas is clean before we send it over to our membranes. The gas is going to flow through here into our GraniteFuel membrane system. Now, we use a three-stage membrane system with Evonik membranes. It's included in a climate-controlled enclosure, if that's what your application needs. The three-stage membrane system gives you a lot of flexibility in operation. It means that you're gonna have around a 99% methane recovery rate. Your final product gas is gonna be anywhere between 96 and 99% pure methane. and your tail gases should be under 1% methane, meaning you can vent it in most jurisdictions. Now, all this together is going to mean you have a clean gas product you're able to put into pretty much any pipeline in North America.